King zone, starting to square off, and Hector Marini throws a couple of left hands. Wells goes down, grabs him around the waist. Now they're back on their feet, and Wells gets a couple of right hands in. Oh, he smacked Hector Marini with a couple of good rights, and now he throws Marini down on his back. Marini can enter over the net. As soon as the Devils control it, the whistle will blow, and we have a slashing penalty, and now we've got Dean Kennedy and, who is it, Dave Hutchison. Dean Kennedy, the 19-year-old rookie, battling with the veteran Dave Hutchison. And Kennedy's helmet is knocked off, but nobody's throwing a punch yet. Now Hutchison looked like he grabbed the hair of Kennedy. Kennedy throws a left hand. And now they break loose, and a left hand by Hutchison, a right hand by Kennedy. And another right by Kennedy, and another right by Kennedy. And they're going to let him go at it. So the youngster, 19-year-old Dean Kennedy, doing quite well in this scrap with a veteran, Dave Hutchison.
And again, this all precipitated. The slash started, and you could see it coming. Bruce Hood just kept things going. No penalties. Sticks were getting up. Elbows were flying.
Los Angeles zone. Poplitsky getting several good lefts in there. Now a right by Poplitsky. Another punch by Jim Poplitsky. Trying to hit his Wells, but he can't get any in because of the long reach that Jim Poplitsky possesses. And now finally they fall to the ice. And that's the signal for the linesman to move in to get them hauled apart.
Peter, I didn't see how it started, but certainly he went toe-to-toe. As you said, Jim Poplitsky landing a couple early ones.
We said they went at it the other night, early in the game. Now it's taken them almost 22 minutes. And now, right back inside the Winnipeg blue line, they are grappling with each other. Kennedy gets a short right hand in, but it's been not much more than a wrestling match right now. And now Kennedy grabs Boschman's helmet off and throws some right hands at him. And the linesman, I would think, has had plenty of time to move in, and Kennedy gets some more lefts in. So Dean Kennedy getting easily the best of this when there were punches thrown. And now they will go to the penalty box. Right at center ice as the puck comes into the King zone. It's Dave Taylor and again it's Scott Arneal of Winnipeg, and Arneal getting some right hands in. Now Taylor throws a couple right hands. And now Taylor throws a couple left hands. And Arneal with a couple left hands. And every time this happens, you gotta be wary of Taylor's injury, the broken hand he had earlier. Taylor knocks Arneal's helmet off and pounds him a couple of times on the top of the head. Taylor's still got his helmet on, and now they're going to break it up. 18:01 to go in the game. The Kings leading 4-2 over the Winnipeg Jets. And Scott Arneal. Now we've got another fight. Here is Laurie Boschman and Warren Holmes. And Boschman has Holmes bent over and throwing some punches at him and trying to pull his sweater up over his head. Well, these two teams, this is the second consecutive night that they met, and now Boschman knocks Holmes backward down to the ice. He had knocked Holmes' helmet off, and Boschman falls on top of Warren Holmes, and they're going to try and separate him now. So, these two teams battling in more ways than one for that last playoff spot, and the Kings leading 4-2. We had, as I recall tonight, a relative penalty-free first period. Did a whistle blow? Here's Korab and Flint getting squared off back at the blue line, and Korab gets knocked down by Willie Flint, and then, while on the ice, throws some right hands at Flint. And I don't know if the whistle blew before the puck went in or not. Bozak scored at the other end, and if it does not count, it's going to be unfortunate that this fight started, because Bozak made a great shot to beat Lemelin. And back at the blue line of the Kings, there was Korab and Willie Flint going at it again.
And we have got a fight going. Paige D'Amico and Jay Wells. Well, a couple of pretty big boys there. Jay Wells, well over 200 pounds. There could be a few guys thrown out of the game here. When a fight occurs, you have to go to your benches.
Court around the head, and now Secord tries to get loose, and Korab, pounding him from behind, goes into the bench with him. Secord tries to throw a left, Korab tries to throw a right, and Jerry Korab throws another right hand. He is really upset at Secord. He's got Secord bent over the boards. Secord threw a left, And now they'll move in and try and break him up. So Jerry Korab and Al Secord bump into each other along the boards. And Korab jumped all over Secord on that one.
Now that's a situation. It was a clean check by Korab, albeit a hard one. But sometimes in hockey, players can accept a check.
Jerry Korab, the former Chicago Blackhawk, while skating to the penalty box, raised both hands up in the air. And oh, then did the fans get out.
Finally, the whistle blows. And now Schneps takes Taylor into the crossbar, and Davey throws a couple of right hands at him. And Nichols and I think Radin have been separated. So in front of the net, a left hand by Taylor to Harold Schneps. Schneps without a helmet. Taylor still with his on. The linesman not attempting to break that tussle up yet between Schneps and Taylor. They look about dead tired right now. They finally moved everybody else away from those two, and now they're going to go in and break it up. Well, the Kings are frustrated. There's no doubt about that. And this is a very... Tanny rolled it out in front, and Marcus Mattsson falls on it there. Now we've got Wells throwing a punch at Neely, and Wells knocks Neely down. And right flat jumps on top of him right in front of the net.
I think Wells really connected with Neely on that right hand. Neely quick to get up, however, and the linesman trying to pry them apart. Neely, actually, now he flips over Kevin Collins.
And squared off, and we've got ourselves some problems. Referee Myers directing the rest of the players to the neutral area. The two linesmen, Capitello and Chucky Commanders, separate Giroux and Brent Sutter. Giroux 2-1 over. Linesman that connected solidly with Brent Sutter. The two Sutters are leading the Islanders as far as penalty minutes are concerned. Wayne with 42 minutes, Brent with 41. They're becoming like the Hanson brothers in Slapshot. The rookie defenseman, the elbow comes up into the face of Billy Carroll. And now play is called, and Bob Nystrom is set to go with Giroux. Giroux had a tussle earlier. He and Brent Sutter drew 5 minute majors, and now Giroux is in it again, this time with Nystrom. Leading Pierre Giroux about a half a dozen right to none. Well, we've gone through all four games in the road trip without any incident. And now we come home and we have a nasty situation with Pittsburgh the other night, and we're right back into it with the Kings tonight. Giroux trying to make a stop. Nice to get him an uppercut there. You see how they grab each other. They try to get leverage by holding on. Nystrom gets his arm loose. They got to step in there and stop this thing. Well, they can't until they get an opportunity. They generally have to wait till the players tire themselves a little bit. Now, you see the rule in effect. The visiting team go to the penalty box. The home team go to their bench. As Nystrom heads for the Islanders penalty box, Giroux, he had a penalty earlier, along with Brent Sutter, for fighting. Goes to the Kings.
Solid hitting in the corner, Hollander. Nice pitch from Allison. There's a hit by Petit. Look out, they're going to go. That's Petit.
And Giroux.
Now for that. And John D'Amico and Wayne Bonney in there with their work cut out for them, trying to pull them apart in the corner. And it all happened because of the play from Kotsopoulos in the goal.
Well, one thing about George Brown,
we're hearing the linesman talk right now.
Here's Fleck. Fleck in the corner being shadowed by Wells. Wells takes a couple of pokes at Fleck from behind, and now they're going to go at it. Banging away at each other on the board. Wells looked like he was anxious to go, and Fleck is always relatively anxious to oblige, I would say.
Whether he wanted to go or not, he had to go once he gave him that little jump in the nose.
Thursday night.
Fleck started. Wells takes Fleck into the board. Oh, Willie gives him an elbow right in the shot. Oh, pretty good elbow. Educated elbow. Oh, there's the second one. Pretty good hook, and then they're at it.
The gloves off. Now they spar with each other. Kennedy, some right-handed shots. Now a left-handed shot by McClellan. Booming him. Kennedy, some shots. They're banging away at it. Oh, now McClellan thundering left hands into Kennedy's side of his face. He knocked him down. A booming left hand. Crushing left hand now by McClellan. And he continues to bang away. Now Kennedy down. Oh, wow. I'll tell you. He stung him with three or four thundering left hands.
Sent back down. We got a little fight going right now. Right in front of the center of the benches there, we got a little bit of an altercation. Number 29 is Joel Otto, and it looks like Russ Anderson is his, number four. They'll just kind of struggle. You want a matchup here? All right. Otto is 6'4 and 220. Anderson is 6'2 and 200. Now they bend him back over. Boy, oh boy. Russ is under fire here. Well, you've heard of a leveraged buyout? That's a leverage something or other. Bourgeois got a hammerlock on Anderson, and now they're trying to break him free. You hear the linesman?
Okay, another shot, crossing both of
you. And the linesmen are saying, I've got so-and-so, you have somebody else. Now the linesmen are threatening the players with a 10-minute penalty if they don't stop.
Take him, they're hitting my face. What the fuck are you doing?
I think he said, what's the fudge like outside? So this
back in the LA zone.
A fight. Look Russ, out, Anderson, Anderson and Nyland.
Didn't take long. Of course, both those guys like to rough it up a little bit and get into it. Russ Anderson, ex-Pittsburgh Penguin. Mentioned Dick only in the second hockey game.
Take him long to get out
here. I don't think there were very many punches thrown in that exchange.
51 games. Look at this now. Now we got Brian McClellan just wailing away at one of the Maple Leafs. He ripped his jersey right over his head, threw about five or six or more right hands. Jay Wells, he pushes Wells. Here they go, and Wells throws a right hand at Brubaker, and now some more right hands as Wells and Brubaker go at it.